What up, Elite Fam? Charles Macro jumping back into Fishing Planet. All right, guys, we are back once again hunting another monster. We're coming back from South America, the Amazonia, and there's a new monster fish. It is a fish technically, but it's cyber, it's robotic, it's something different they're trying to do. We're going after this electrical, well, we're getting the electrical leader to go after the cyber piranhas, all right? So this one is interesting. It's new. This just released. They released four new monsters recently, and this is one of the newer joints, guys. All right. So I am on stream. Shout out to the Elite Fam. And I'm doing this kind of as a mixture, like I did with the other one, to do it on stream with my peoples, but I'm going to still edit it later. So if you ever want to come be a part of, man, make sure you come join the streams. This is what we do, man. We have a great time. We got a lot of great people who come and support and help out as we fish, man, and we help one another. What's going on, Brandon? What's up, Ace? How goes it? How y'all doing? Welcome to the stream. So, yes, man. Work has been busy for the last couple of days. Family, I've been busy with family type stuff, so... we getting back on the stream and do the thing, man. All right, so I'm going to show you what I am fishing with, guys. Now, when you're going after the electric eels, you want to come to this spot I'm going to show you on the map. These coordinates are 200 by negative 200, this negative 300 area. It's this little cubby. You'll come in right here. You can either go straight down and come through this little intestine and come down this way and cut up, or you can go all the way down the shark way and cut back this way. Say you were hunting sharks, but it's right here in this area, 200 by negative 300, basically, in this little cut. You'll know you're in the right place because, again, it's a little cut off in the cut, all right? Hey, what's up, Hammer? What's going on? Oh, what's up, D? What's up, D? What's going on? Yo, shout out to Dentonia. Hey, what's up, Delta? What's good? Shout out to Delta Warfare. It's one of my guys, dope channel. We've been around. We started out back in the day. How goes it, man? How everything been, man? Yo. Say not much. Okay, you in the Congo. That's what's up. You making that good Congo money. Hey, what's up, Hunter? What's going on? Welcome to the stream. So, guys, if you are jumping in, I am streaming as usual, and we are here going after the new Cyber Piranha, but I'm also recording. I'm going to edit this together later on as a hotspot or a way to catch the monster fish, man. So thank y'all for being here. So there'll be parts where I'm talking, and then there'll be parts where I'm going back, you know, recording for the video, but we doing that all on stream, man, so y'all kind of see how I do it. But yes, so when you're going after the eels, well, let me go back and look at the mission real quick again. To get the electric leader that you need to catch these cyber piranhas, you have to catch five eels. Again, we're at the eel spot. I just showed you where you catch those on the map. I've already caught four of them because sometimes it takes a while to catch the eels. They don't bite very quickly. So it can take a while. Just throw out as many rods as you can. Or if you can only throw out one, you just got to be patient. Now, when catching eels, you'll know it's an eel because the water swells up just like it does with sharks. You'll see it really bubble up, and that's how you know it's an eel. The eels like to kind of pump fake quite a bit. They'll do fake outs, but they will eventually bite. If the water doesn't swell up, it's not an eel. It's probably a piranha. Hey, yo, I'm doing good. Can't complain. Tony say, you got one meal so far from yesterday. That's dope. Hey, good money. Hunter say, like 18 markers. Yeah, man, always throwing out a bunch of markers, man, all over the place. Once you start using the markers like that, man, you get addicted, or I get addicted. So, yeah, I got markers all over at every lake that I started using them. What's up, Wolf? What up? What's going on, Wolf? Now, I'm going to assume that you'll see that electric shock in the water. I don't think that's just from the eels. Y'all let me know, guys, in the comments if the eels always do that or if that's the new cyber piranha that's generating that little electric shock. I want to believe it's the cyber piranha because I don't remember the electric eels doing that. But I don't know that for sure. Hey, yo, shout out to Dentonia watching on Twitch and on YouTube. Okay, so that electricalness is the eel. Okay, okay. All right, that's cool. So that's not the cyber piranha, but it'll be dope if you see a super big shock for those cyber piranhas. But that is the eel. They put that cooler animation in there. Now, I'm going to show you what I am fishing with to catch the eel. I'm using my feeders, using the La Casa Dora 11-1, the Torbellino 11,000. This is a 70-pound max drag 72 on that rod. I got braid at .013, titanium leader, of course. And then I put a smaller X-Series barbless 4-aught on this one. On this one, I put the 8-aught. This is my Mackenzie 1210. It's an 80-pound rod. The Filler 11,000, a 79-pound mass drag, basically 80. Fluoro .003 through the fluoro on that one. Titanium lead, of course. I got the barbless 8-aught on this one just to see if it filters out the eels just a little better. All right. So that's what I'm using, but you can use whatever. The eels actually aren't that heavy. You could have a lighter rod. We'll say 40, 50 pounds, you should be fine. If you want to go super light and fight, you can do that too. All right, all right. So you heard, I like the exclusive event fish. yeah, I do. Now, that elusive Atapaima at Maku Maku, I had to forget that one for a minute. That thing take forever to catch those fish you need to get the lure or the bait, but... Yeah, man. Say the exclusive events. I'm trying to do a lot of these new missions that drop. You know, it's always fun. Let's see. You have a 2017 event fish on your account if I want to look. Okay. Okay. I have to check that out. So is that from one of the, like, the tournaments that come out? Rowdy Bass and Leprechaun Fish. Okay, okay. So that's like those seasonal holiday, like you said, the different type of events. Yeah, I have caught a few of those. Like, you've been reeling them in. The actual fish, the main fish of the event. Trying to think, which one did I catch? I think I've only caught like one or two that was recent. Yeah, the St. Patrick fish. Okay. Yeah, I was doing the Christmas one, but that was like way too much. And I got busy around the holidays trying to catch that Krampus fish. So yeah, I didn't get it. Now, Dent, do you go after all the event fish? And are you able to catch them just, you know, going through, like, the daily cycle and catching whatever lure bait? Or do you got to buy the packs? Or, like, do you use the bait coins, you know, to get the lure and things of that nature? Because that's why I didn't do the Christmas one. The grind was too crazy. You had to catch, like, 1,000 fish. It was too much. Gave me potato salt and thought it was cool. Now, did you post in the Discord? Because I'll go in there and look in the channel if you put that in the Discord. Otherwise, I have to just check it out. Hunter, say, found my channel yesterday. Love my voice and videos. Hey, look, glad that you enjoyed the videos and the voice. Glad that, you know, that I guess they help and they're entertaining and they help you catch fish. Hunter, what lakes are you fishing at? What lakes are you fishing at? What fish are you targeting? D said, these fish were only St. Patrick's Day week in 2017. Okay, I got you. As far as you're aware, they haven't come back since. Okay, okay. Yeah, it looks like they try to switch it up, do some different things. Even though I think some of the same ones have come back, like the Frankenfish. Hey, what up, Carson? What's going on? What's going on? How goes it? Welcome to the stream. Oh, and let me say this. Let me say this again. I'm hunting the electric eels right now, and we're hunting the cyber piranha. But let me say, it's a lot going on in the world. So I just want to send up, you know, peace, blessings, send prayers up to everybody out there. Y'all know some of what's going on, man. It's a lot of turmoil going on. And the developers of Fishing Planet are actually in the country that was dealing with that invasion. So, man, I hope everybody is safe and a lot of, you know, make it through. And I hope there isn't much, you know, bad things that happen. I just say that, you know, YouTube is, you can't say the wrong things, but I just pray for everybody's safety, man. And I hope that there is as few casualties as possible, man, in this, man, they can work this thing out. Cause you don't want to see that type of thing going on, man, nowhere in the world, man. And, not only the devs, but I hope all of the, you know, the citizens are okay. Again, I got to look into, because I like to study and get, you know, information and get informed on things. So I haven't dug into it. You know, I know most of the general information, man, but just to see why things are really happening. But no matter what, man, you don't want to see people going through that type of stuff, man. So I pray and send my prayers up, man. Hope everybody is okay and that they make it through this situation. Hunter, you say, man, you just started. You in Lone Star Lake and Mudwater. You think those are the names. Okay, yeah. You just starting out. Look, I've been trying to do it. I've been talking about it for a while. I am going to eventually do it, but I want to start over. I'm on PC, so either on Xbox or PlayStation or both, I want to start and kind of grind up to like level 20 or level 40 just to show people how I started out. I do have my hotspot videos you can check out. Those will always help you. If you come through the stream, there are always people here that can help you. But, yeah, just kind of starting and doing my little step by step. Because I learned it as I went. I was new to the game like everybody else, and I kind of learned the mechanics of the game and the way everything worked. D say you just posted them in the Fishing Planet Picks channel. Okay, I check them out. Let's see. Wolf say you just saw the electricity in the water while I wasn't looking. Oh, for real? Yeah, I was just talking, asking if that was the new monster, but I think that's the eel. But that'd be dope if that was the monster too, generating that electricity. Let's see, Natonia Hunter. I can show you some spots on Mudwater if you need. Yeah, Hunter, like I said, we got a lot of good experienced people in here, and they are, and that people that come through the streams in general that can always offer tips and you know, help you find fish, earn money, get your XP up, like whatever you're doing at that time, man. Come through, feel free to holla. Let's see, you struggling to make money when you travel, it costs all your money. Then you got those licenses. Now, since you started out, I'm gonna tell you something that I did when starting out because I didn't know, because the game doesn't explain it well. You do know that you can go to the next day and you don't have to leave, right? So when your net fills up, because I know when you first started out, you got a smaller net. When your net fills up, you don't have to leave to cash in the fish. If you leave, you got to pay travel costs every single time. So what you want to do is just go to the next day. Go to the next day. There's a button you can press. If you're on PC, it's T. For time, if you using a controller, you know, you press SX on Xbox, or I think that would be square on the PlayStation. I can't do it because I got rides out. In fact, I'm going to pull them in just so I can show you. Let me know, though, if you know about how to go ahead and cycle to the next day. You might be familiar. Oh, was something on the line? All up. I'm going to show you just in case you don't know. If you do know, this will be for people who are new. If you knew and you don't know, when you fill your net up, 10 seconds. Right now, it's in the cool down period. All right, boom. There you go. So if you hit X on Xbox controller, square on PlayStation, this map comes up, and then you can just fast forward, but you got that next morning down there. Just go to the next morning. Don't ever leave the lake and then come back to cash in your fish, because you'll lose tons of money. You'll never earn enough money to save to upgrade. So, yeah, just go to the next day, just in case you don't know. What up, THRU? What's going on? Hey, I'm doing good. Welcome to the stream. What's up, GTV? Shout out to Global. What's going on? How goes it? Hey, what's up, Pomodoro? Pomodoro44. You. What's going on? What's going on? Oh, I saw the spark. I think it's helpful, guys, if you're watching this. I think it's helpful to throw your line where you see the electricity. I think that's where the eel is roaming. You want to catch them where he's roaming. And let us put that over there. Dentonia say, I don't want to share anything. Okay. Let's see. THRU say, how's the Brazilian map treatment tonight? Well, I started trying to catch some of these eels before I started streaming. Up, oh, you see, y'all see that? Now you see that swirl? That's the way the water will swell up when an eel is about to strike. It doesn't always strike though. Sometimes it'll hit you with that fake out, but that's what it'll do. You'll know that's an eel. If you get a bite and it doesn't do that first, it's just gonna be a piranha most likely. I wouldn't even reel the fish in unless you just want the money. Let's see. But yeah, the Brazilian map. Yeah, I was here before I started streaming trying to get some of these eels just so we wouldn't have to wait because eels are slow. So we wouldn't have to catch all five of them. So I got four of them knocked out. So we just trying to get that last one. It looked like that was it. But it looked like it ain't happening. And oh, I'm going to assume that the cyberfish are right here. Up. We got two bubbling. One of these going to strike. We got two eels popping right now. One probably won't. One probably will. Let's see. Ah, man. Both of them ain't do nothing. That is trash. These eels be funny. These eels be funny. Let's see. Go for bowfin and catfish and mud water. Okay. Pomodoro, do you know where you can catch the tiger muskie at St. Croix? I do. I can't, like, look up the coordinates right now. Guys, do y'all know where to catch the muskie? It's in the area where you catch the pike, but you got to throw it at this certain area. I think I marked it when I caught it, but I have to show you when I go there. If I don't go there tonight, like, depending on how long it take, I could try to run by there. But otherwise, you come back through on another stream, I'll find it for you. Guys, if y'all know where that muskie is at St. Croix, y'all let Pomodoro know, man. It's appreciated. Let's see, use cut bait if you can, and a 23, okay, pound leader at the spine near that log. Okay, appreciate that, Dent. Hey, shout out to Dentonia. Hey, an elite legend. That is what's up, man. Hey, thank you, man. Shout out to Dentonia for the support, man. Shout out to all my members, my patrons, man, super chatters, and just everybody who supports, man, everybody who comes through to the streams, to the channel, man. Thank you, man. But big shout out to Dentonia, man. We need one eel, guys. We waiting on this one eel. If you've already caught, I don't know if Wolf is still in here. If you've already caught the cyber piranha, let me know where you catch it. I'm gonna assume it's still right here. This is where I'm gonna cast because piranhas are here, and I'm gonna assume it's in the same place where you would catch these eels to get that leader, but I don't know that for sure. So if you know, if you've caught it, if you've seen it, let me know. A hunter say, you trying to complete the Lone Star mission part two? Okay, you haven't caught a smallmouth buffalo, you watch the video. You haven't caught the smallmouth buffalo. Watch the video on it, but if I had any key tips. You can catch the buffalo. So if you watch the original video, that does work. But the bread with honey doesn't work as well. It still works, but the devs nerfed it a little bit. And if you're early level, try to get flies. Flies worked a lot better. I went and tested it, and I did an update video for 2022. So I don't know if you saw the update video, but flies work way better now than bread with honey, although it can and does still work. It's just way less frequent. So, and if you looked at the original video, I have another spot. It's a spot where the mad-eye buffalo can be caught, and it's by the lily pads. I'm standing in the same place, but I threw to the left more. Up, there we go. It's bubbling up, guys. This might be that last eel. This is what you look for when you're about to catch the eel. The water will swell up like this. There we go. We got it, guys. We got it. Yes, look for that water to swell up, and you know it's an eel. If it doesn't swell up, it's most likely a piranha. But yeah, I would use flies. There are a few other later things that work better. You can still throw them at that same location I show in the original video, but try flies out. Use, you know, I think in the video I show it, but maybe a one or a two hook. It doesn't have to be a huge hook. And you'll eventually catch one. And you got to be patient. Okay, yeah, no worries, no worries. Oh, try marshmallows. D'Antonio say try marshmallows. Again, he's just starting out, so I don't know if he's at the level. I'm not sure what level marshmallows are. But, yeah, if you can try marshmallows, another good one that worked, I think it's corn and peas work as well. Those are going to catch catfish, though. It's that's another one that works really, really well, but it's a later bait, so you wouldn't be able to use it right now. Okay, blood worms are good, Drew said. The only reason you're not doing these cyber piranha, because you have to leave the Amazon to go to the other lake and then come back. Too much money. Okay. Really? I did not know that. I did not know that. Yeah, I didn't know you had to leave, but we going to do it. Let's see. Semolina balls. Yes, semolina balls work as well. Semolina balls are the bait that I originally used to catch that. So, yeah, they do work really well as well. And again, try flies. That seemed to work well with since they kind of updated and changed things. Hunter say you level 10, so anything over that you don't have. Okay. Okay, they level 14. All right, guys. So we've caught the electric eel, the fifth one. You got to catch five to get this monster. So now we should be rewarded with the electric leader. Let's see what this is. All right, all right. Great work. You got the electric leader. I'm now ready to hunt for the cyber piranha. Nice, nice, nice. Now, if I do have to go to another lake, we might not get this on this one. All right, so let's look at the next steps in the mission to see what we have to do. You have a difficult task in front of you. Catch all the cyber piranhas in the lakes in South America. Oh, use their spare parts to create a unique adamant leader. Kind of like adamantium, like doggone Wolverine, which is no match for mega piranhas, the new creatures of evil genius. Equip the electrical leader and go into battle. Remember that cyber piranhas are more active in the dark. Oh, man. You got to catch like 20. Wow. I didn't know that you had to catch this many, guys. I ain't even looked at this joint. Maku Maku 21, Marin. Okay, 27, Amazon 33. Wow. Well, most likely we're not going to. I'm going to tell you now. We might not catch all these this stream, but I'm going to go ahead and get started. So we'll go to track that, boom. And let's find this leader that they talking about. I'm wondering, do you get more than one leader? Or is it only one? Let's see. Okay, you get five, so that's cool. So I can throw out multiple rides. So we'll put that one on this one, boom. And I'm gonna go ahead and throw that one in the water right here. Right, chill. Really, I could leave this spot just so we don't even have to worry about eels. But eels, they bite so infrequent that I'm not even going to worry about it. And then we'll pick this other rod up so that we can put that leader on it. Let's see, dough balls, corn. Okay, yeah, dough balls, corn. Yeah, a lot you can use. What's up, Big Bot? So you join the stream. Nah, you good, you good. We haven't been on that long. We've been on for a little minute. Don't get me wrong. We've been on for a little minute, but you good, man. You right on time. You right on time. All right, so we've added the leader. If you have the boat with the DLC, with the ride stands, then, of course, throw out multiple rides. I'm going to actually put on a smaller hook. That way we should catch more of these doggone piranhas, piranhas eat everything. And if y'all know of a better, I mean, piranhas are everywhere out here, but if it's a better location, I will move. I'm going to go ahead and pull out my my match rod as well. We'll use this one here. And I'm going to put a smaller hook. And we'll put the electric leader. Bam. I will leave this cut bait on here just because, but I'm going to put at least some smaller one. That's expensive. That cut bait is expensive. I'm going to use these meat chunks. These meat chunks are really good if you're at Marin going after those catfish. You'll catch mad unis with these meat chunks. All right, cool. We'll keep it shallow. Let's go. Hey, Matias, what's going on? What's going on? I'm doing well. I'm doing well. How are you? How are you? Let's see. Hunter said, you've also been targeting spotted bass for the money. Are there any other good money fish at... Okay, look, I thought that was finna bite. I thought that was the cyber joint. If you're at Lone Star, bass is the best fish. Pickerel are decent too. Up, we getting some activity. Oh, I gotta go to nighttime, guys. Doggone it. I gotta go to nighttime. Let me pull these rods up so we can go to nighttime. Yeah, bass are the best money fish. You could do drum. Drum has slightly better XP though for leveling. Up is swelling up. That's an eel. I'm going to go ahead and take this eel if it does bite. Ah, man. Them eels be pump faking. You're at Mudwater? Yeah, are you at Mudwater or are you at Lone Star? All right, let's go on to the nighttime, guys. See if we can catch some of these fish. Yeah. Really, I should just be able to throw about anywhere and we'll catch these jammies. Got the Mackenzie out. And I may move around. But hopefully all we'll get is these piranhas right here. Mike, what up, what up? What's going on, Mike? Welcome to the stream. Yo, what's good, what's good? Let's see if we can get us some of these piranhas. Hey, what up, H? What's good, what's good? Welcome to the stream. How goes it? Okay, yeah. If you're at Lone Star, yeah. Bass are the best fish. Just grind bass. And as you continue to level, prepare to go to Emerald Lake. It's still going to take you a minute because even though you're going to save money and level, you're going to buy more equipment. You're going to upgrade your equipment. But once you get to a certain place, go to Emerald Lake. Stack you up like maybe like 5K. And that way you can travel, get your travel fees, your license, and still have a little bit left to go to the next day. But before you go to Emerald Lake, make sure you got you a good spin ride, which you probably have. And not a good, like high level. Just get you a spin ride. And then also get a narrow spoon, gold, silver, depending on your level, purple or black, they may not be unlocked yet. And yeah, go at the walleye. Throw it straight out, stop and go. You'll make plenty of money in XP at Emerald Lake. That's like the first serious farm right there. That's an eel. I don't need no eel. I mean, I take it, but I don't need it. Let's see, golden casting spoon is good. Yep. Twitch motion. All right, we got a hit. I mean, unless these cybers. Nah, that's an eel. I was about to say, unless these cybers do like the eels. Nice, nice, nice. Brandon, you say use blood for the cyber piranhas? Oh, dog, I'm changing my ride. I did not mean to do that. Yeah, you saying use blood for the cyber piranhas? Piranhas eat about anything, so you usually can just use whatever. But we're going to use blood. That was recommended. So let's see what this blood do. Woof. So you caught the monster at Maku Maku. Nice, nice, nice. I couldn't catch all of those fish, man. I got tired of waiting. Hey, congrats. Okay, you said a smaller hook. All right. All right. So to try to ensure I catch these piranhas, we're going to put a smaller hook. I was using my 4-aught barbless. I'm going to go with this barbless one. Could probably go smaller than that, generally speaking. But we're going to do this barbless one. And I'm going to put blood on here. Shout out to my man, Brandon. B, if it's another location that's better for the piranha, I'll make a move. Oh, something's getting a hit. This ride is going off, but I don't know if it's the cyber or not. We're going to find out, guys. That's the red eye. That is not the cyber. Now, I don't know how frequently these bite. It may be a slow grind. We're going to find out. This is the last one, and since that you do have to go to multiple lakes, it's the culmination of the 3 new monsters that they put out, and then this being a 4th, it looks like they're going to make you work for it. But that's cool. That's cool. That's what we'll do. Let's say you hate nighttime fishing. It depends. Early on, you don't catch a lot nighttime fishing. But as you go through later lakes, there'll be lakes that nighttime fishing is the best fishing, like Emerald Lake. Emerald Lake is best to fish nighttime, 9 to 5. But you'll be making so much money that you shouldn't mind at all. Oh, we still got the speaker, guys. I got the speaker on. Let me change that up while I'm thinking about it. Bam, much better, much better. And we'll put some blood on here. Let's go. Hey, what's up, CT? What's going on? What's going on? How goes it? How goes it? Welcome to the stream. Did I upload the instrumental version of Show Love Shout Outs? No, I did not. I didn't put it up yet. I actually had to, like I say, dig it up because I hadn't had the instrumental accessible in a long time. And thank you for the reminder. These last few days have been real busy. Real busy with working fam. So, yeah, appreciate that reminder, Wolf. Hey, Hunter, so why do you hate night fishing? Is it just that you don't catch as much, or is it just because it's nighttime? Man, you should be catching these cyber piranhas at a way higher clip. I'm gonna change locations. All right, Wolf. Hey, you know I always appreciate you stopping by, man. Doggone it. Take it easy, man. Get some rest. Peace and blessings. Yeah, check you later, Wolf. Let's see, you don't even know what to go for. Okay. Yeah, right now, because you're early, I wouldn't even worry about night fishing that much unless you're just trying to keep going, because you also don't have a light. Like, I got a light on my hat. You see how it got dark and it comes back? You'll get a light later after you fish at, say, Emerald Lake and you catch so many fish. Uh-oh. There we go. Hey, we got our first cyber piranha. Hey, eek, cyber piranha. Nice. Let's see if we can get a few more of these. I doubt I'm going to go for all 33. I'll probably grind that out like tomorrow while I'm doing some work or something. Just sit here and see what we catch. But yeah, we got one of those. Let's see, threes up. We getting another hit. Let's see what this is. Is this a regular one? Bam. Is this another one? That's just a red eye. They got me on that one. I thought that was it. Let's see. But 377 negative 220. Okay, I'll check that out. 377 negative 220. Actually, I would have did it before I cashed it. I had already hit the button. Once we catch another one where I can pull up the map. Oh, here we go. We actually get some activity now. What is this? It's just a red belly. Okay. Okay, that's okay. She'll be back. She'll love me in the morning. 377. Okay, 377, 220. That's around the bend right there. That's around the bend. All right, down, then up. Then all the way around. Down, up, all the way around. All right, I'm going to change locations. We'll check out this other spot. Appreciate that, Brandon. See if we can get a higher frequency of bites. All right, bam. Let's back it on up. Oh, I need some engine. Let's back it on up. All right, so we got to head down this way. I'm looking at the map, so I can't really see what's going on. No, I'm trying to go in the other direction. Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm good. Bust this right, boom. We heading all the way up. Brandon say use 3-aught hooks, okay. So, yes, we are hitting another location. You gotta drive up and go around the bend. Yeah, man. So what lakes are you guys fishing? Like, where are y'all at right now? Where is everybody fishing? What fish are you targeting at your current lake? I don't think I'm down far enough, but let me double check. Pull this map out on them. All right, here we go. Let's see. Are we there yet? Now I gotta go down a little further. 77233, yeah, I gotta go right down here. We almost there. Let's see. CT said, damn, you going right up on land. Got four-wheel drive. Hey, I know, right? This boat is a beast. Can't stop this boat. It does it all. It'll transform into a plane. Dent say you going back to the hammer, going back to the Congo for more XP. Nice. Yeah, the Congo is where it's at. I was actually considering getting that other pack as well, that Wild Africa, and head back so I can get over 75 so I can go back there. I might grind it out, though. I'm really starting to consider just grinding it out as opposed to, we got a tree right here. Yeah, I'm really considering grinding it out as opposed to buying the DLC. But I kind of want it, though. I'm debating. All right, let's drop our brake. Let's look at our map coordinates once again. All right, yeah, we there. So I'm gonna throw forward into the little cut. See what we get. Let's get it. Actually, let me throw my other feeder out first. Brandon say you fishing your bed, targeting your pillow. I hear you on that. Hey, I'm gonna be right behind you once we done with this stream. I was up real early this morning. I've been working all day. Went out and got outside a little bit, played a little basketball. My son was running around, had me running in circles. Was out with the fam. Yeah, I'm a little well out. So I know the feeling. Okay. H3 say you at Rocky Lake. Nice. What you targeting at the Rocky Lake? Well, it must be trout. You going after trout or you going after the monster? CT say you haven't been playing much lately, been focused on the grind. I know that's right. That's what's up. Shake, what up? So you at San Juan. Oh, farming them sturgeon. Nice. Those sturgeon are good money. They good money. Depending on your level, they good XP as well. But their money isn't commensurate. Or the XP doesn't really equal up to the money. Whereas most fish that make that amount of money and are that big gets you a little more XP. I don't know why they like kind of nerfed the XP on those, but sturgeon are good money. And it's decent XP. It's all right. Bot say you at Rocky, but you don't know good trout rigs. Okay. So you spin fishing for trout. The best thing to go for trout is spinners. If you got any spinner, if you early, you got those bullet spinners. I'm gonna have to reel it in so I can show you. Yeah, spinners work well for trout, any type of spinner. I'm gonna show you what I got in my bag. I'm in my bag. Na 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 na. This barbless nano spinner works well. I think you might have to spend a bait coin on that though. It took me a minute to buy it because I didn't want to spend that bait coin, but they have missions that you could complete by having a barbless nano. So yeah, and I think this one's when I won actually. This X series as well. Any spinners. I put up a lot of my spinners. Yeah, these bullet spinners work well. You might not be at a level where you can get the bullet spinners. Any spinners work for trout. Let's see, anything else that I remember off the top. Yeah, spinners definitely. Insects as well. Trout like insects if you happen to be bait fishing. Let's see, Palm say you at Northern, you hunting them Northern Pike at St. Croix. Nice. Yeah, St. Croix is where it's at. St. Croix is where it's at. Which one is better, Emerald or Rocky? Emerald is more of a farm. Like, Emerald's easier. But Rocky is funner to me, if that makes sense. And once you know really how to work multiple rides, you can make as much money at Rocky that you can at Emerald. But when you first starting out, Emerald is like, it's easier. Because all you got to do is, again, have a cast in a narrow spoon, a spin ride, you throw straight out, and you stop and go. And you catch a walleye like every time. Walleye going to get you about $250 to $350, you know, maybe $200 to $300, $400 in the money. They good XP. You can farm at Emerald and get your level up to like 40 if you stay there, but it gets boring because you're really only catching one fish. They have pike there. They have certain panfish there. They got Xander. What's the other fish? Sauger. Those are there as well. They're like Pike's cousin, but it gets so boring just farming them. But you'll make $100,000 before you get bored. Rocky Lake, there's more variety in the trout. You got about 4 or 5 different species of trout. So it's fun reeling those in. The Colorado joints, the cutthroat. Cutthroat. Yeah. So I like the trout lakes. I like Rocky, Falcon. Rocky's like the little brother. Falcon is like the big brother. And White Moose is like the papa bear. Like all three of them are the same, but they different levels, and you're going to catch some big fish once you get to White Moose. Let's see, put the electric leader on your casting rod. It might work. I was thinking about that, Brandon. I was thinking about trying it. Let's see, 250. You've only had 100% max per fish. Really? At Emerald Lake? Okay. And again, it might be because you early, but once you start getting bigger hooks, your lure, once you were able to get a bigger narrow spoon, yeah, you should be get about 250. I've gotten about 300, 350, depending on how big the walleye was. But yeah, we talking about walleye. That's at Emerald Lake. If you still fishing bass, you're not going to make that much. Yeah, we talking about walleye at Emerald Lake. Falcon Lake is good money and a lot of variety. Yep. Like I say, Rocky, Falcon, they all really good lakes. Let's see if I ever played 7 Days to Die. I do have 7 Days to Die because I like a lot of simulators. Like I used to play Empyrean. I got a lot of survival type sims, right? So I got 7 Days to Die and I was trying to learn it and, you know, get it down because you really got to get it down because you only got 7 days. I didn't really perfect the technique, though. Let's see. Medium spoon, crankbaits, spinners. All right, we're going to try some cranks. We're going to try some cranks. I mean, some spinners. I'm going to try spinners first. So, yeah, I do have 7 Days to Die, but I didn't learn it well enough to get as good as I wanted to be at it. You know, I really handle those raids, those attacks. We're going to do this 2-op bullet spinner. Let's see how that do. That buzz bait actually might have worked. can you put something else right here with this bullet spinner? Like you do with jigs? No, okay. All right, I'm just making sure. Maybe you can put one of those tails. All right. So we did get one. We did catch one cyber piranha, but now it's like they drying up. But I'm going to try this bullet spin. Oh, I didn't put the leader on. That might have been bad. Yo, they should let you get electrocuted. Like, what happens if you catch one of these fish and you don't have that leader on? Does it electrocute you? That would be kind of dope. All right, there we go. Let's see, 3K XP per fish, 2K money. Nice. Hunter, you been at Lone Star. Okay, all right. All right, Hunter, take it easy. Let's see, what is today? Wednesday? I may stream tomorrow or Friday. I usually stream on Thursdays, so but it just depends. Like I said, work been a little busy, so I couldn't keep my regular schedule. And worst case, maybe Sunday. So, yeah, just look out for the notifications. Look out for the notifications, and, yeah, I'll be back streaming once again real soon, man. But, yeah, Hunter, appreciate you hanging out. Peace and blessings. Have a good day tomorrow. Good rest of your week. Let's see. You can increase the day cycle to give you more time to build for horror nights. Okay. Yeah, I really needed to, like I said, get more practice in and figure out how it goes. Hunter say, okay, you know, I got those notifications on. Hey, that's what's up. That's what's up. Hey, see you later. Take it easy. Have a good one. Yeah, these piranha ain't doing nothing. Let's see, I got to do this at Maku and Marin. Oh, how many is this? 30, that's 60, it's like 80 fish. Let me see if Twitch can get me some activity. Like, they're not biting at all. Even the regular piranhas ain't biting. Oh, there we go. Hey, we got us another one. Oh, let me take a picture with this. I ain't take no picture with it. Look at your boy, got his light on. Got my light on. Hey, that was a good suggestion, man. That was a good suggestion, Brandon. We got a hit. Oh, let me mark that. There we go. Gerald, what up, GB? What's going on, man? How goes it, man? How you been? Let's see if we can keep getting these jammies on their bullet spanner. Yeah, this is going to be a very arduous grind. Say good and tired. Hey, I feel you. Look, I had to thug it out to even get on the stream. I was like, whoo, I'm a little whoa. Been a long day. And I got there and was running around a bit. Like I say, with the family. you know, trying to make sure I get some exercise in and things of that nature, man. And yeah, feeling it today. These piranha are playing right now. Well, I see this is going to be a serious grind. Again, I didn't know. I thought it was just one fish. I didn't know. Up. We're getting something. I didn't know it was multiples. There we go. I think this might be a nudging. Is this a nudging? This a regular. It's a regular schmegular. I mean, my feeders ain't hitting anything. Like, not even just regular piranhas. It's a little odd. Got another hit. Nah, that's not the cyber. All right, guys. It's looking like they're not hitting like that. What I'm going to do is grind it out. And in the next one, I may try to get to all three of them. Now, I know this is going to take some time. So this might take a couple days, or it's definitely going to take a couple days just based on this frequency. But I'm going to stay here, try to get it up to at least about 30 and go to the other lakes and get, you know, at least about 90% of those catches done. And what we'll do, we'll finish them out together on the string. Hopefully I can do this in a day or so. It's just going to take some grinding. But yeah, hopefully I can catch these jammies in like a day or so and we can wrap it up and see what that reward is. I know they show you, but we can get that reward, man. Keep it moving and grooving. All right, guys. So yeah, man, we gonna go ahead and wrap it, because this is gonna take a while. Wait a minute. Is the cyberfish like hold on? There we go. Boom. Let's keep it going, cyber piranha. The bullet spinner doing business. I repeat, the bullet spinner is doing business. Let's see if we can get one more. While we going to the well. Uh-oh. Is that another one? Oh, yeah. There we go. I mean, my goal, my internal goal was to try to get at least 10 of them. But they was playing. But it looked like now they want to get a little action going. That's cool. Let's see if we can get us one more, guys. We'll twitch it out, then we'll switch it up to stop and go. That seems to be effective. Ah! That might have been caught. So they playing. Yeah. They is, for real. It should not be, you know, take this long or be that difficult to catch the piranhas. It's a lot of them, so it's going to take some time, but they should be hooking real easy. Fairly easy. I ain't going to say easy. They should be hooking fairly easy, though. Come on, piranhas. This is the first time the piranha's disappearing. Trying to hit incognito mode. Trying to get one more. Let's go, Cyber Piranhas. I'm going to recast this real quick. See if it helps. Kind of want to throw over here. I mean, piranhas bite everywhere. Trying to see what's back there. All right, let's go again. Let's go again. Let's go, Cyber Piranhas. One more time to the well. All right, Cyber Piranhas, where y'all at? Where y'all at? All right, guys, lest we get a fish, this will be the last cast. Last cast. Last cast. And I actually, now that I'm at a higher level, I might throw some fluoro on here. That'll probably help, because I think I got mono line on here. That was the only line. Well, I think it came with it, but then that was the only kind I could buy at my level that matched the weight, or at least got close to it. I gotta remember to change that line. All right, guys, we caught four of the 33 here at Amazonia. So again, I'm gonna keep grinding it out off camera, see if I can get us very close to 33, at least get about 30, 31, and do the same at the other lakes, get really close to the amount that we need to finish out these monsters, guys. So, yeah, man, again, make sure y'all come through. We'll be back on the next one, man. Peace and blessings. Again, prayers up to everybody, man. Hope all is well. And, you know, hope everybody is able to stay safe in different parts of the world, man, because we got a lot going on right now, man. But, yes, man, thank y'all all for stopping through. We'll be back. We'll do it again on the next one, man. And we're going to get these Cyber Piranhas, guys. All right. All right, guys. So like I said, I'm going to holler at y'all on the later on. Charles Macro, Fish and Planet. Man, thank everybody for stopping through and hanging with me. And I'm going to holler at y'all. Peace.